Hi, my name is Grace Shalom Hopkins, and welcome to another episode of Spin Weekly. Yes! It's been a while since Baby Bean has joined us. Today we are going to be exploring Perendale. I said it Perendale the first time, and now that's stuck in my head, so I will forever doubt my pronunciation abilities of this word. It is a really interesting breed that I had never heard of until I ran across it in the BZB Fiber store, which I will link down below because that's where I got it. And I was pleasantly surprised. It's really not like anything I've ever tried before. So I went ahead and I, just like the Angora Merino breed study, did the voiceover while I did a technique. Now this time, instead of just spinning a single, which is what I needed for a project last time, and the only way I wanted to spin a plain white single is if I had a good, like, secondary motivation. Boop. Boop. So today's secondary motivation is I wanted to test out the blending board recipe. Oh, sleepy sapper. I wanted to test out the blending board recipe that came in the May Paradise Fiber of the Month Club. Now I did it on purpose. I discontinued my Paradise Fiber of the Month Club for my spin-along, so I didn't get backed up. But then I forgot to renew it, and so that was a mess. So we're missing the one that's now. So that would be May, because today is May. It's a Paradise Fiber of the Month box in the past. I skipped this one in May on accident. It should be here next month. That was my fault, because I was dumb. So anyway, they included a really cool recipe that I wanted to test out. So I used it and I carded up a ton of Dorset Defender packages. And Dorset Defender is one of the perk levels for my Patreon patrons. So if you are a Patreon patron, you will probably be seeing these Rolags. And I cannot wait to see what you do with them. And like I said, I'm going to give you all the gory details while I'm actually blending it. And I will see you on the other side. Alright, so here I'm sorting the Paradise Fiber of the Month kit into piles. I did add some extra fiber, but I ended up not liking the sorting that I did. I felt like the ratio to white and colored fiber was too low. I wanted mine to be more white heavy. So I ended up scrapping all of this sorting later on. But it was good because I ended up experimenting more. Alright, so here I'm going to do the white heavy version. This is more true to the Paradise Fiber of the Month recipe card than the version that is more colored fiber heavy. So let's talk about the Perendale a little bit. I found that it drafted like butter. I mean, it didn't stick to itself at all. I felt like it had next to no tooth. It just slid. It reminded me of a luxury fiber, a plant fiber. It just slid like butter. The cotton, however, was really funny to work with. I had trouble not getting big clumps in one spot, but I didn't notice any problems when I spun my sample Rolag. So I just filled in the weaker spots with cotton. Next, I added clumps of the Merino, and the recipe card mentioned that you should leave white spots in between, and I just did little clumps here and there, and I didn't layer them up. They were really thin. I think that was a big key. Later on, I ended up putting more fiber on top of itself, hoping that that would help me use up more of my colored fiber, but I didn't like the result. Here I'm just adding more cotton on top, and again you can see how liberal I was with the white portion of fiber and how that really helped balance it out. with the layer of Perendale on top. I think I'm saying that right. And the sari silk. And then I'm going to add some Angelina. And that is from the green. I think it's the May. No, not May. April? One of the past Paradise Viper of the Month Club. And it's in a bronze tone. And then I just roll it off the board as usual. And I really love the pastel effect that it creates. The Perendale, however, because it is a short staple length and it's so slip and slidey, it did take a bit of finagling to kind of get it off the board. I was expecting something a little bit more toothy and longer staple length. I really like how these turned out, though. I think that the ratio of color, like I said before, I feel like I'm repeating myself. I really like how it turned out, and I feel like it would be a really good way to take a braid of multicolored fiber and repurpose it. So there's a lot of ideas that this technique can spark. Okay, so next I am adding in some gray fiber. Again, I'm trying to beef it up, and we're a little overexposed here. Don't know why that's happening. So I'm trying to beef it up with that gray fiber and some of the cotton, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a lot more of the colored fiber than I did on this last one, and you'll see the difference. I don't actually think the gray really altered the look all that much. I think it got mixed in with the white and ended up just being a pale backdrop. So I'm adding in some faux cashmere and then the merino blobs. And you can already see that I'm going a lot heavier here. Baby Bean really, really wanted to tease on the edge of the blending board, which would have been a terrible idea. So I was trying to fit this in while she was away. And it was not going well. So you can see it's really, you know, I'm thinking, I'm like, nah, I don't know what I'm going to do. So I start to layer them on top of each other. Because you can see on the floor that I had sorted it into piles. And I'm like, how am I going to get these piles to fit on the board? So I just went with it, and you can see that the board is pretty much covered with colored fiber. And the faux cashmere was giving me lots of grief because it was such a different staple length to the Perendale that I had a really hard time getting that first one off the board. Also, now that I'm watching this, it actually matches my dress. I did not do that on purpose. This is a really wimpy little Rolag. I thought maybe I could get him, but I couldn't. He's just a wimp. So you can see here, they're really bright in comparison to the pale ones. All right, but now let's talk about the Perendale. We monologued about the actual technique. Now, Perendale is a breed of sheep that was developed in New Zealand. Romney was the main breed. It was introduced in New Zealand in 1853, but over time, it really lost its vitality and low lambing persons, and just overall, it wasn't doing well. So the farmers were really dissatisfied with the results they were getting from their commercial flocks, and so they began to experiment with crossing Cheviot and Romney together. And in 1956, which, that's a lot of time that's passed there, 1956, Sir Geoffrey Perrin at Massey University made a Perendale sheep by crossing a Cheviot over a Romney. Just a little bit later in 59, the Perendale Sheep Society was formed in 1959 with the object of advancing and studying this breed of sheep. And today it's actually gaining popularity as one of the most popular breeds of sheep in New Zealand because it has a good fleece and it's excellent in all types of terrains. It's a well-behaved sheep. They don't have any trouble lambing and they produce excellent meat. They're good in all different diversity of environments. Overall, banging sheep. As for the fleece, Like I said, it feels really smooth, and it doesn't have a high luster. It's low in luster. It's not shiny like Romney. It's springy and crisp, but it's actually surprisingly soft. The average fiber diameter is 29 to 55 mi 55 35 microns. It's got 125 millimeter average staple length, and the fleeces themselves are between 3 and 4.5 kg on average. I really think this is one that people should pick up and try because it's such a weird and unique breed. So I got mine from BZB Fibers, which I have linked down below, and I recommend you go check that out and get some of your own. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that recipe blending and the really interesting look at the Perendale. Note how I avoided saying it pretty much the entirety of the breed study voiceover. I mean, that was skills. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you've ever spun Perendale, let me know down below. What were your thoughts, feelings? How do you use this fiber to the best of its abilities? I am really fascinated by its history, how the farmers took a weakness in their flocks and they were able to play with the strengths of other breeds and create a whole different breed. I mean, genetics are so cool. They just are. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you don't want to miss out on any of these shenanigans, hit the subscribe button, comment, like I said. And as always, this video is brought to you by our friends on Patreon. If you are interested in financially supporting the show in return for super awesome swag, links down below. Also, side note. I had my husband shave the side of my head, and rather than my normal cute side shave, I have received the basic training version of my haircut. So yes, I do in fact look like a dork for a while. Baby Bean is rapidly deteriorating to sleep, so we will sign off now. Say goodbye. Yeah, now you're happy. Did you just need attention? Yeah, did you just need attention? Oh, another PSA. If you love staring at my child's face and listening to our shenanigans, we have a secondary channel, Gray Shalom at Home, and we have just released our first cinematic film on there about our pool day, so you can check that out. Now we're really going.